Hey folks, this is Best in Slot. Welcome back to Planet Zoo, welcome back to Elderwood Zoo, and welcome to the brand new Arid Animal Pack, officially releasing tomorrow with 8 brand new animals for your Planet Zoo game. Frontier very nicely sent me early access, so as a super sneaky YouTube boy, I can showcase some content a little bit earlier on. But you'll be able to get a hold of it tomorrow for yourselves. Today we're going to start off first of the Arid Animal Packs then. We're going to work on the Somali Wild Ass, basically. Our donkey-ish this kind of thing going on. And we're going to start off with a train station. The idea is you're going to hop on the train. You're going to go up into the mountains a little bit. You're going to look down across all the trees. I saw these images online of like national park train lines. And this idea of having a mountain on one side and like this forest below you on the other side, maybe a bit of a water, a bit of a river or something like that. And it looked really beautiful, so I thought, okay, I'd like to do something in that sort of area. And I bit off way more than I could chew. This is one of those builds where for a very long time I was like, I may have been overly ambitious here. Like, this may have been too much. But it came together in the last half hour, like literally the last half hour, until the last half an hour of this build, and this was a long build, folks. I was a bit like, yeah, this was a terrible idea. This was a huge mistake. I shouldn't have done any of this. Whoopsie-daisy. But anyways, we're building a train station. You can see it directly connects to the right. Initially, I wanted the train station to go through the mine that you can see right there, but it just wasn't going to happen. I'd have to delete so much stuff, and it's a pretty area. I didn't want to ruin it, but we're right next to the entrance to Barry's Barley Bonanza. And the idea is, so you're going to hop on the train. This train station is meant to be, you know, fairly modern looking. It's, you know, meant to blend in with some other parts of Elderwood Zoo. It's meant to be, you know, a building they've created. It's all very official. I hate these train stations, by the way. I'm so sorry to rag on the game when we're hyping up a new update. But the way the queues work and the way the exits and entrances work on this is really obnoxious. You can't build like a good platform without having to layer stuff over the top of it and have that stuff too high up. It doesn't make sense as a system, like, because it has to be elevated and you can't remove the curb on elevated paths. It's really annoying. Anyways, swapped back over to brick. I decided we don't have many brick buildings at all in the zoo, but there are some over in the little town that we built for the Halloween pack. And it just kind of felt appropriate, and I was, you know, cribbing off a real-world train station design, so surprisingly huge amount of time spent in this early portion just building the train station. The interior, which is obviously nowhere near done, but the exterior is getting there by the end. Anyways, so the point is, there's a train station, you hop on the train station, it's meant to be modern, it's meant to be, you know, built by the council, it's like an official thing. And we're kind of leaning into that Elderwood staple at this point, I feel like, where something has happened and they decide to turn that something into a money-making opportunity, you know, a way to bring in money to the local community. Elderwood is very capitalistically driven in a lot of ways. So, thanks for a suggestion from one of my moderators over on Discord. We're going to be going to an old mine. And thanks for a suggestion from one of you in the comment section. The thing that they've built in the old mine is like an old American Wild West sort of town. Obviously, we've not built that yet. We're doing some stuff along the way. But the idea, you know, those very cliche ones you see. I'm kind of thinking like the episode of Community where they go to the old Wild West. That's just any American sitcom where they go to like a fake American Wild West town. There's a saloon and a bank and, you know, loads of the Doctor Who episode where a town called Mercy, I believe it's called. We're going to base it on Mercy and stuff like that. So that's very much the idea, and we're going to fold everything else into the build like that so I can do things a little officially. We can build some fun things. You know, I'm thinking like the cat, you know, the desert cat that's part of this park. Part of this pack, I should say, could be like the saloon cat kind of thing, you know, just little things like that. I don't know. I'm concerned I'm giving myself too many building interiors to build, but we'll see how things go. Either way, the idea is that, you know, Elderwood used to be a bit of a mining town. We've talked about that before. That's long been in the plans anyway. So they've hollowed out this sort of canyon area where they've been digging for resources. When that was finished and the mines were abandoned, or maybe for some other reasons, who says this little town isn't going to be haunted? The town is probably going to be haunted. I feel like old mining towns should always be haunted. Anyways, so it's an old mining town.
the miners were long gone, so the council and the people decided, okay, well, we've got this big arid section in the middle of our beautiful national park, let's do something a little different with it, and they turn it into, you know, this Wild West frontier sort of town. I know I'm not talking about the build, I'm just building a train station. It's not much to what am I gonna say about it? It's just, I'm just like, they're just cribbing. Just building some pillars, some concrete sort of foundations. Anyways, that's the general idea, and that's what we're gonna roll with today, basically. Well, we're not getting to the town today. We're getting to the entrance of the town. There was a lot of work involved, and if you like rock work, you've been for a treat. If you like landscaping work, my God, did I have to do a lot to get to this point in the build? And that's really the part of the build that feels slightly ambitious, to say the least. You'll see what I mean when we get further into the build. But terrain-wise, the build is pretty insane. But we'll see what happens. I really wanted to have like an overhang here, but I just couldn't think of a nice way to do it. Ideally, it would be in glass. I think if I'd done it in glass, it would have worked. I just feel like a train station should have an overhang, but I guess there's a large indoor section, so it doesn't matter as much. But I feel like glass wouldn't have worked with the vibe, I suppose. Anyways, it's still Elderwood, though. We're still going to keep some things. So you can see we've got our benches and bins there. Like I said, I'm pulling things from the little town. And even though we're going to be in an arid section and it is predominantly brand new foliage and brand new rocks and all of that, you know, I'm still going to use some of the same stuff. You'll see what we want to get there. But first of all, wanted the building to look slightly less stupid. I kind of like stuck this brick underneath it and then it didn't line up with the foundation, so I had to shift the entire... I'm very tired. Sorry, I only woke up about 5 seconds ago because I only got this build done yesterday because I was working on the bloody sloth build all week. And then, look, this is like the third episode of the Planet Zoo within 3 weeks. People better appreciate I've been putting the time in lately. Anyways, I'm alive. Oh, right, yeah, so we should mention just before we get going, you know, same thing we've been talking about all this time. If you want to see lots more arid pack, you want to see all those brand new animals, please do just take the time to throw me a like, throw me a comment down from below for the algorithm, all that kind of jazz. I feel like YouTube's maybe onto me now, and they know I'm doing it, so it's not working anymore, but we should keep trying, you know. I'm holding up my part of the bargain. So many of you have been so fantastic about it and commenting and letting me know what you think about the builds and all that kind of jazz, and I really appreciate it. Just gotta keep doing it. Anyways, moving on. Building some windows. I spent so much longer on this train station. I don't build buildings. You know, it's just not in my wheelhouse, really. And I spent a long time looking at this ugly brick shell and just trying to think, how do I make this look more interesting, basically. It's not my wheelhouse. Maybe I should build a wheelhouse. I don't know what a wheelhouse is, but I want to build one. Anyways, it's track time. So this took a lot of, I spent like 2 hours on this before I even started recording, just hollowing out landscape in the area and bleeding stuff and getting things ready. A lot of time was spent trying to decide where this track is going to go. And you can see me swiveling my mouse around there. That's me thinking, right, I know what I want this to look like. So where does the track have to go to make that work? You know, where do I put everything? And obviously, there are problems if we've got this area on the right-hand side. You've got the city, the little town we're going to build at some point. That's going to be like the fishing village down by the docks. We've got an exhibit right here. God knows what's in there, frankly. Cannot remember, but that's part of the radio tower build that we did. But I just had this image in my head I really wanted to make true of where you go up into the tree, you go up into the, well, you go through the trees, you go up in the train, and you look down to your right, and you see all these trees below you on the ground, like you're driving or training, I suppose, over this huge swathe of like lush forest, you know? And that felt very Elderwood, and it's something I actually want to do a little bit more of later on in the build, like properly maybe do a big train journey sort of thing. We are going to have to do a boat ride. What I realized when starting this build, you remember I was going to do a dam. That was the initial idea. One of the reasons I didn't do a dam, even though I have blocked off the water at one part where I have to go fix that, is there is no way to get to that far side of the park. Like, the Halloween Town and the Tropical Zoo both block it off entirely. There is no possible way to put a path over there. So I think it's going to be a boat ride from the fishing village across Elderwood Lake to the far part of the lake, basically, and that will get you access to the second part of the town. And that way we kind of split it nicely into two, so we can complete this half, then build the boat ride, then build the other half, is the idea. Anyways, thus starts the terrain work, and this isn't even entirely finished by the time you guys see this video, but it is getting there. But you'll see what I mean. It's just, it's a lot. And this game struggles, I would suggest, with huge waves of terrain. Up close, it can look really nice. When there's tons of it, it tends to look a little... I don't know, the textures don't really hold up, I would say. So the way to fix that, typically, with normal terrain, is you use rocks. But the problem is, of course, when the area is this humongous, using rocks suddenly becomes very difficult. It takes a very long time, as we'll see. But anyways, what I'm doing here, hollowing out like a little canyon. The idea is that we can build, we don't even have to do like the whole average pack in there. You know, we've got 8 animals. We could build some in the rest of the park if we wanted to. There's definitely potential for that. But the majority of them are going to go. Also, I really like this button. I've never used it before, by the way. This flatten to terrace button. I thought it was really cool. Yeah, so hollowed out this canyon, and that's where we're going to build the town and the arid pack. I need to give it a little bit more elevation and stuff inside, but it looks really weird now. For a long time I wasn't really happy with it. It came together. I had a few ideas at the end how to save it, and I think I did, but we'll see what everyone else thinks. But it needed to feel separate. Given the terrain we're going to be using, it did need to feel a little bit separate from the rest of the park. The idea for the actual exhibit, which I haven't talked about despite being 11 minutes into this video, 12 minutes into this video, is you've gone up through the trees, you've looked down over the, you know, forest below you, and then you burst through into this canyon, right? Like we're seeing right here. You burst through into this whole new environment, this whole new world. I want it to feel like a transformation as you come through this hole. I was looking for images of the wild ass online, and there was all these ones of them on these sort of arid mountainside kind of things. In very grassland-like environments, I've got to say, the game has them listed as desert only, but they definitely live in things that look grasslandish to me. You know, I was looking at these mountainsides and they were covered in foliage, like way more than I'd expected. Anyways, so it's like this sort of flat plain on like a semi-steep mountainside, and they were just sort of gallivanting around the mountain, gallivanting around the hills, having a lovely time. And I thought, because we're dealing with limited space here, you know, this place is probably about the size of a tropical pack, and there's 8 animals rather than 4, 5, I suppose, if you're going to include the exhibit animals. I should integrate one of the builds into the arrivals. So I really like the idea of you bursting through this new area, and then, you know, you look to your left and you can see the town laid out before you, and you know, everything you're going to see in the future, and you can see this huge canyon. Eventually, I'd like to build like some giant mining equipment and build that into the wall of the canyon. I think that'd be really cool, because I think it's gonna look a little bit dull potentially if I don't, you know, it's gonna look a little bit samey, so it needs to be broken up. The wall needs to be broken up a little bit, so I think some giant mining equipment that's been abandoned there would be really cool. Also worth noting, I want to make the train loop, but to make that happen, the train track would have to go right through the tropical zoo. So what we're gonna do is when it does come to the looping at the very end and it needs to loop back around, the train journey back is going to be basically entirely underground, and you're going to go through the old mine what's underground, basically, is the idea. And we'll have like gold deposits and maybe build like an old prospector animatronic, won't be moving, but you know what I mean, just stuff like that, you know, like a cheesy Disney style haunted mine ride. I think it's going to be haunted. I haven't really thought about the story beyond the mine has been abandoned for some reason. You know, maybe the official line is that they ran out of things to materialize. Maybe they ran out of things to farm, to mine, but you know, maybe there was another reason. That's all I'll say. Maybe there were other reasons. But anyways, yeah, so the wild ass, the idea is simply that as you enter the area, you can look to the left and you see the town, you see the whole area, and then if you look to your right, you're going to go past their habitat, and they're going to come right up against the train as you go past, where they're living in this very naturalistic sort of habitat. Everything we've built lately has been very, it's been a zoo, and everything's been very controlled and by, you know, the council and by people, like me. And that's been very purposeful. You know, we built a tropical zoo, so it's nice for a place like Elderwood, which, you know, is a national park and should have naturalistic habitats, to have a naturalistic habitat, just an exhibit that it's just them in the wild, and that's all this is meant to be, them in the wild. Obviously the people know about it and maybe throw a few things in there to help them, you know, toys and feeding equipment and stuff like that, but generally speaking it's meant to be a naturalistic habitat. So I'm hiding the staff away. I always feel bad for my staff in this, because I just hide them in the mountains and they never get to leave. I'm just doing some little tests here to make sure that the ass can't escape, which it definitely could initially, because I haven't really planned around that, frankly. And yeah, so that is the exhibit right there. And you can see it doesn't look great. It's this big blob of brown boringness. That's some solid alliteration there. It didn't come together for a long, long time. It really made me nervous. At about, I think this whole build, if you include the time I took doing other stuff that I didn't record, I did some rock work, I did some terrain. You see, I've done all the sort of nature work around here, or a lot of it. I did all the grass, I did all the rock work. Just, you know, made the area look pretty while I was watching a film. It's probably a 7 or 8 hour build. It's one of the longest builds I've done. That's a long time for me. I don't spend that long on builds because they don't time lapse well and I'm lazy. So probably about 7 or 8 hours total. And I would say until hour 7, I was like, this was a mistake. I shouldn't have done this. This was a terrible idea. I really had the idea of having all this foliage everywhere, like that people have been coming to the train station and have been tracking foliage into the park, you know, stuff like that. I like that idea. Yeah, I always say that very often my stuff doesn't look good until the very end. Like, it kind of comes together in the last half hour, but whew, did I have to have... I really had to have faith in that to make it work this time around, because I was very apprehensive. And I'm still not totally convinced. We'll see how I feel today. I've not seen it in the cold light of today, so we'll see how I feel. Just a little bit more work on the building. This was... I don't know why it took so long to realize this, but this is what I should have done earlier on. Used the limestone just like we used back in the town. Because, you know, it's a proper building, it's something they've built themselves, the council, so it makes sense that it would have, like, little details like this and just little fancier things. So, just doing that, making it look a little bit nicer. It really bugs me. Like, you've got all these limestone trims, right? You've got that one, which is placeable anywhere. It's not a grid-based one. But down to the bottom, if you search for limestone and go down to the bottom, there's, like, 4 or 5 limestone trims that are all on the grid, right, that you can place onto your buildings in a grid-like fashion. Except one of them. For some reason, there's like 5 of them, and then the 3rd one is not on the grid. They all look the same, they're all the same idea, they're all limestone trims, but just one of them is randomly not on the grid. I have to imagine it's a mistake. I'm always unsure about, like, sometimes having things on the grid, really useful. Sometimes the fact that you still can't... It's actually one of my biggest problems building-wise with this game, is that you can't take things off the grid in a proper way. Like, you can take them off, but you can only rotate them horizontally, right? You can't rotate vertically or anything like that if it's a grid-based item. And I don't know why. Like, that just seems so pointless to me. Like, just let me disable the grid, potentially. You know, let me turn that aspect off if need be. I understand why you can't rotate things and keep them on the grid. Like, if I rotate my roof piece 47 degrees vertically and then horizontally a little bit and then diagonally, I get why it can't stay on the grid. But I don't see why I can't just take it off the grid and do what I want with it. It would give us so many more building options. It would give us so much more stuff for free, basically. Like, I don't know. That's probably a much more difficult change than I think it is, but it's one I'd really like to see. Anywho, doing a little bit of interior work. So, like I said, the interior of this building is not done. I'm not going to say it's ever going to get done. I don't like doing boring buildings. I don't know what I'll do with it. I just need, like, a little staff area with, like, a little queue. We can build a little queue. A little queue's fine. And a little ticket station. Maybe some vending machines. A couple of benches. Yeah, okay. It's not that big a deal. We can work on it. We can work on it. But it came together at the end. The exterior I quite like. The lampposts, I think, weirdly enough, made a really big deal. And just hanging some lights up in the interior from the ceiling. And we'll put some of those old-timey ones as well. Just, again, that slightly Elderwood look of, like, the fusion of the modern and the classic, basically. I'm quite excited about this town. Like, I know I don't do buildings, but the idea of building, like, a full-on Wild West saloon frontier town is quite exciting to me. I'm excited about the saloon and the bank and the jail. The jail should be in the police station, right? How we integrate animals into all these. I'm thinking, oh yeah, no, the saloon can't have the cat. My idea for the saloon, I think, I believe, all right, I don't know for sure. I'm being very incoherent here. I believe the exhibit animal for this pack is a pit viper or something like that. I haven't actually checked. I believe it's a pit viper, something akin to that. You know what? Let's bloody check. Right, so you guys can keep watching on the Steam. Planet Zoo Arid Pack. Let's have a look. It's... oh, it's a professional video. You just... Oh, Desert Horned Viper. No, that makes more sense. Obviously, it's rock time. But only around the train station. It's not even proper rock time yet. There's so much more rock time to go. How are we doing? We're over halfway, though. See, it felt like it took a billion years, the other stuff, but I actually probably spent more time on the train station than anything else. I forgot what it was called already. Was it a viper? For God's sake. What was it called? I just looked at it. It's a viper. So I thought the saloon would be called, like, the Viper Pit or something like that. You know, just like a rough and tumble little bar kind of saloon sort of thing where all the hardy people go and there's always people gambling with poker cards and stuff like that. And they call it the Viper Pit. And they call it the Viper Pit. I was going to call it the Viper Club, but that sounds more like a nightclub and it doesn't really suit the Wild West. But the Viper Pit or the Viper, or just the Viper Saloon or something like that. And it's because they've got a Viper in the back or they've got a Viper on display or something like that. You know, there were Vipers in the area and the owner has one as a pet because he's that kind of guy. So that's one exhibit idea done. God knows what we're doing for the other side. Oh, the camels is going to be like a stable or something, I'm sure. Like you can rent a camel, go for a ride, all that kind of jazz. So that's three. We'll come up with the others. Choo-choo! Wow, I really can't believe it took me this little time. Anyways, I haven't done this war live yet. This is one of those builds where I've got like 8 episodes to work on the area. I think I've done more than my fair share for this exhibit. Here I'm just going through and hearting the foliage we're going to be using for the pack. Establish that nice and early so I can hit the heart button and I've got access to the required foliage very easily. I am using... Hiccups. I've got a mixture of desert and grassland is what we're using. And thus begins the rock work. So much rock work. My God. So the initial idea was, again, I was looking at real world images. They don't really have any of their normal rocks. They're standard tiger rocks, desert rocks, savanna rocks, whatever that look like I want it to look like. It's a rocky environment and then very bushy and shrubby, spiky grasses, dry grasses between the rocks. And the rocks don't sit in the environment too much. They kind of sit on top of the environment a lot more than I usually do. And color-wise, they're quite light, they're quite strong, and they stick out quite a lot amongst the environment. So that was the initial idea. I realized pretty quickly, at the end of the day, it doesn't work on its own because, like I said, the texture, the rock texture, it's fine. But if you're going to have like a big mountainside, a big area like this is, it just doesn't look good on its own. I just don't think you can do big swathes of terrain in this game and have it look good. And that's not necessarily criticism. I think that's a near impossible thing to do. You always need foliage or rocks or something like that in basically any game, I would suggest. So the Tiger Rock comes in and is meant to be the landscape itself. It's not meant to be seen as like an individual thing. It's meant to be part of that landscape. And then the other rocks sit on top of that. Basically. So, and it also ties it a little bit more in with the rest of Elderwood because we're using the Tiger Rock and that's what we've been using for the entirety of Elderwood Park. And it makes sense that it would be the same rock as the foundation for this pit, even though it's been excavated and it's dried out and stuff like that. I dabbled a little bit here with using some of this darker bluish sort of rock. Maybe it's like slate or something like that. But the faux rock is kind of what started bringing this together. I realized my piles of rock weren't big enough, and I also, like I said, I needed brighter rock. The images I was looking at, it was just really bright rock in this sort of grassy landscape, and it really stood out. It's really pretty looking. So I kind of wanted to use that. So I'm kind of just putting the faux rock kind of over the top of the existing rock. The faux rock on its own doesn't always look fantastic. You need to jumble it around a little bit and maybe blend it in with some other rock. I mean, it looks great for faux rock, don't get me wrong. It looks fine for that. But in terms of looking like real rock, it helps if you can blend it in a little bit with other things. And you can see I'm not really putting it into the walls. I'm not really just putting it into random spots. I'm trying to make it look like it's piled up sort of thing, like these individual little rock formations. Eventually there's going to be some copy and pasting. And actually, there's two things I did at the end of this video that made me a lot more confident about doing this going forward. The first is the copy and pasting. Obviously, we're still going to have to do a lot of rock work, but I am definitely going to build like a few different shapes of like very varied rock formations and then just copy and paste them and rotate them and hide them in different spots. And you cannot notice, I swear. But it makes my life a bajillion times easier. Something this scale, because obviously I need to do the entire canyon wall in rock like this. You know, I want the whole thing to be just as detailed. Something like, it would be impossible. Like, I mean, it would be possible, but it would take a gajillion hours. And I don't have a gajillion hours. I'll be dead. I think. I don't know how long a gajillion is. But I would probably be dead. So, there's going to be some copy-pasting, but you won't notice, I don't think. You guys know, right? This is our dirty little secret. Don't tell anyone. I think we're going to do the tour as well after the Arid Animal Pack for the entirety of Elderwood, because as I've said... Oh, no, we'll have to do the town first, won't we? I kind of like the idea of splitting it into two. This is like season one, and then when you get on the boat to go to the other half of the park, that's season two, right? So the last thing we need to do in season one is the fishing village. So although, I mean, we could... Are there animals in this pack I could include in a fishing village? We could... Well, let's just focus on this for now. See how things go. Anyways. Initially, we wasn't going to do any foliage. Usually, I use the grass and I put it over the top of the existing grass, and that's how it looks good. But if you do enough of it, it kind of starts to work. And even though it's arid, it doesn't mean it's not covered in grasslands, basically. Like I said, this is... Yeah, usually in a desert, I wouldn't have this much foliage. But... And the Somali wild ass is only a desert animal, according to the in-game information. But again, I looked at their environment on Google Images, and they were in an environment very similar to this. So, screw it. Makes sense. And I can't build an area without grass. The fact that I can't use the terrain grass tool is really upsetting. And that's another thing I'd love, by the way. If we get like a dry grass tool or something, like an extra terrain option, it'd be fantastic. When you're doing a park like this in a fairly lush default area, I can't remember where we are, North America grasslands or something like that. It's very hard to build arid areas because you just... The terrain tool options aren't there. It'd be nice if we had more options, like in, say, Jurassic World Evolution 2, which has now got all the fairy foliage. It'd be nice if we had the terrain options for every park in every park, basically. But I know it's quite optimistic. There's probably a mod for it, but I'm not touching mods in this game until they stop updating it, which is probably going to be never. Planet Zoo is doing remarkably well. Like, it's crazy. Someone posted the numbers the other day on Twitter. More people are playing Planet Zoo than they are playing Planet Coaster, of course, but more people are playing it than they're playing Jurassic World Evolution 2, for example, and various other games. Planet Zoo, and that was before the update, it just continues to have a really dedicated fan base, people who keep playing the game. And that's really cool. So, and that's why we keep getting DLC at the end of the day. That's why it just keeps on going and going and going. Never ending. There's so much DLC for this game now, it's wild. Actually, shall we have a little look while we put some trees down? Yeah, I needed some height. You can't... Oh, you might be able to hear that, my bad. How many DLCs are there? Someone make a guess. I'm going to guess 11. Something like that. Oh my god, it's more than that. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. Not 14, including the Arrow Pack. Yeah, I think this is the 14th DLC, not including the soundtrack or the deluxe upgrade pack. This is the 14th DLC. That's wild. Jeez. Been playing this game for a long ass time. Anyways, here's where the copy and pasting started. It was just no way it was going to happen otherwise. Just no way. I was losing my mind, ladies and gentlemen. I just couldn't imagine doing all this. And it actually helps in a way because I start to... It sounds ironic because I'm copy and pasting. And I'm making changes. You know, I'm deleting rocks that I think stick out. There's a few there that I don't like that I do delete later on. The thing I'm copy and pasting could be better. It's all very flat, but that's just kind of the style of the area. It's just kind of like... You see, I'm making changes. Doing little edits here and there. Deleting the ones I don't like. I need to build like a very varied, bigger rock bundle that I can rotate that's like even on all four sides. And then I can rotate that and use that and kind of develop that like that. But I just think it looks instantly like really good. And I don't think you can notice. And it wasn't until this very point I was like, yeah, okay, it's coming together a little bit. You know, it's getting there now. It's what seemed impossible suddenly felt doable because it's all well and good building this area, but knowledge that I had to build the rest of the canyon in the exact same style was driving me, like, just breaking my heart. I don't know what to tell you. Just absolutely losing it. It's just, the more we put in as well, the more, like, rock work there is in there, the more varied it'll seem. Oh, it's raining. Nice. This was the other thing I did. So I said there's two things I did at the end to kind of bring it together for me. And the second thing was, it felt too separate. It didn't really make sense. It's a mining colony, canyon, town, sure. So they've dug out a big pit. But there's no reason it has to be a big canyon on all sides. And there's no reason it has to be completely exempt from the rest of Elderwood. There's no reason the rest of Elderwood can't be encroaching into the area. So that's one of the things I started to do as well. I wanted the redwoods to look like they're encroaching. You know, nature is once again taking this area back. You can see it's already sort of overgrowing much more than it would have been in the past. Apparently that little penis took a long time. Don't they always? That was a weird joke. You see it's come together a lot. There's still... there's too many of the same rock in my copy and pasted rock. So if I'm going to do this, I'm going to build a very varied rock thing. But it definitely started to come together. And just having more trees lining the area just made a lot more sense. You know, there's no reason it wouldn't have started to grow over time. And also, I see deleting the canyon wall down there. So that bit's just going to be flat and just going to lead straight into the forest, basically. We can even use that area to build. This is limited in build space as well, so that potentially opens me up. Because obviously the tropical zoo is right there. The town's on the other side. Like, I can't really go anywhere else than where we've gone here. And we're still going to use the old same signs. We can't really have an animal sign for this one. Maybe I'll put it down when we build the train station in the next video. We'll build like an old-timey train station. We could do an animal in that as well. We're going to be building... like, each episode's probably going to be a new part of the town. So it'll be like the mining stuff. It'll be the saloon. It'll be the stables. Which would have made sense for the wild arse. Yes, I see that now. saloon. The police station slash jail. And we'll build all these hopefully distinctive buildings. And environmental work around them. And our town will build up over time. And each of those will have an animal featured in some way. That's the general idea. And we'll also find a way to tell the story along the way. I definitely want like a big mining area. And I definitely want like a haunted mine ride. I don't know where we're going with a haunted angle. But I don't think anything in Elderwood is haunted. We had Bigfoot, but that's not really haunted. The asses were stuck, as you can see. Which is never comfortable. What are you doing, step ass? anyways. But yeah, there you go. That is it. So obviously... lots to do in the area, but we've got 8 episodes to work on all that. 7 more, I suppose. Look at this lovely blurry shot of my canyon cave thing. Like I said, initially, I actually spent some time. I hollowed this area out even more. I emptied it out. I built room. I built a train station in this mountain initially to because I thought that was a nice idea. Because we've always got the tracks already here. But this is a mining thing. It's not really a train thing. And this really just lends a little bit more credence to the theme we're building with... The mining town anyway, which needs a name. Don't know what I'm going to call it, but it definitely needs a name for our old-timey frontier town that's haunted. Right, anyways, we will hop in-game and I'll give you a proper tour. I'll see you in a sec. Right then, folks, here we go. So, as I say, you approach as you normally would. This is the only way across here. You have to walk across the old Elderwood bridge here, the old mining bridge. So eventually, as I say, the boat is going to go and take you over there. Because there's no other way across that. Anyways, so you head across the bridge. You are a train. You can head left if you want to go to the tropical park that we built last time around. Oh, swing bada bada. So very slow, not good. Or you can head to the right and go to the new train station, which probably needs a little bit more detail work on the roof. Looking at it. And it also needs an interior, but ignore that. I haven't done the sign yet. Ignore that as well. So you head inside. Not sure what that is. Is that a vending machine? It's a vending machine that's in the wall. So there we go. I hadn't seen that before. Okay, so head inside. Ignore all this. And there is the chair. Look at it, just sitting there nicely waiting. Beautiful stuff. And yeah, so you've got your little train station here. I've sort of dabbled some little things around. I've got some leaves everywhere. You know, it's been trundled through. This is the queue area. This man's got a fantastic moustache. And obviously did all the rock work and stuff in the area. If I gave you a nice little zoomed out view. This is kind of part one of the build. It isn't part of the exhibit. But the little train station on the hill is part one of what we built here today. This is all the stuff I did off camera, this sort of area around here and all this kind of rock work and terrain work, yada yada yada. Anyways, let us hop onto the train itself. Why not give this a proper ride? Open. Bam. Ride camera. Start test. Seat. Choo-choo! Right, so this area, obviously, on the direct right now, this is where the town's going to be, so that's going to look a little bit boring for now. Eventually, hopefully, that'll look... Yeah, the idea was that you'd see the town below you as you go up in the train, basically. I actually haven't done this, so I'm quite excited to experience it. Choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo! Choo-choo. So you see the town over there. God, you can barely move your head in this thing. And you start climbing the hill nice and slowly. It's meant to be, you know, a relaxing train ride. It's meant to be scenic and such. Go through the tree line. And this is pretty similar to what I wanted. You see we're still climbing all the way up here. And we're going to drop down again in a second. The idea was simply I just wanted you to be above the trees. And I wanted you to look out to the right and see Elderwood sort of splayed out ahead of you. I can't turn any further to the right. My neck doesn't go that far for some reason, so it doesn't really work. But just very dense forest. Oh, that tree's floating, aren't you? You are. Very dense forest, you know, foliage that you just can't see inside. You can't see the bottom of it at all. It's just trees and trees and trees and trees and trees. And you see little glimpses of things like the radio tower over there. You see a little, the radio sign from the radio station. A little bit of an exhibit over there, just little glimpses of things, but you look down and it's just trees all the way across. Pretty much the idea. Obviously this bit needs rock work, but I just couldn't be, you know, just couldn't bother, frankly. There's so much to do rock work wise and I've put so much time in already. I wish I could turn my head a lot more than I can. It's slightly annoying me. If I swap, there you go, look at that. Isn't that beauty? Yeah, it looks great. And yeah, you can see Elderwood there in the background. And then so all this foliage, all these trees, all this forest. Obviously, we'll do some rocks on this staggered area here. I'll just build a copy and paste thing. And head into the mountain. Things get dark and spooky. Spooky. And then you burst into the light again. And suddenly, it's a whole... Wow, you really can't see that sign. It's a whole new world. So you'll see the entire thing there on the left. And on the right, you see the Somali wild ass habitats. You swing by. There they are. Hey, guys. Oh, little jumpy boy. And, yeah, I guess that's about it for the train ride for now. And then it's going to sweep down there, and that'll be the rest of it. So let's hop out of there. Let me fix that tree. It's going to annoy me. Always, stuff like this always happens, because I'm making the trees float purposely, because that's how you get sort of the varied height. And as long as you can't see the bottom, it doesn't really matter, right? Like, that... Like, there's a few trees here that are all floating, but I wanted it to look... I just think that looks really cool, having that forest below you on one side. And then as soon as I build up the mountain here a little bit, it's going to look a lot better. It's pouring rain. But you see, I've started to sort of stagger the trees in. This area's been lowered. I'm going to lower that even more. This area's been lowered entirely. I just needed to make sure that when you're in here, you can't see the rest of the world, basically. You know, because it's all this and it's so awkward looking, especially with this arid environment, it's important that you can't see outside that. So that's going to have to be solid trees and mountain, but we'll get there. Anyway, so you can see the difference. The idea is this is going to be the same all along the side. I'm going to do the mining bit probably over here. Now that I think about it, I was going to do it over there, but probably over here. Let's take a look at the exhibit a little bit slower. So you go through. Unfortunately, because of how the train's designed, you can't really see the sign, but you see it there. That's the first thing you're going to see on the left. Right now, it's Hog Hovel, but it's going to be... Need a name. Somali... Or Ass. Somali... Scene. Something about a mountain. I guess it doesn't have to have alliteration, but they do tend to. It'd be cool if they could. Very open to any ideas and suggestions you may have. Definitely let me know in the comment section down below. And we'll end with a couple of, you know, little glamour shots of the Somali Wild Ass if you want to stick around for that. And I will see you lovely folks very, very soon. So please do throw me a like and a comment down below if you want to see more of the Planet Zoo Arid Animal Pack. Come back tomorrow to Steam for yourselves, to get hold of the pack for yourselves as well. And I'll see you lovely folks very soon. Thanks for joining me. Cheers much of as always. Bye-bye.
Reaching out.